Here at Unity, we're trying to take some of the handmade components and then use the mill for them. Makes it a lot more precise, and we can do things we'd never be able to do by hand. This one, now with buttons into these recessed, precisely machined pockets, springs to the right size, and much more robust design, allows everything to go together better, last longer, and be smoother on the hands. Here's a little bit about how we do it.
So as we just saw with Eric playing NeonFM over there, we've been working hard here at Unity to try to get the buttons working in a much better way, just more precise, softer, easier to activate. And the main thing that was required in that is a very, very accurate panel that holds all the micro switches. Little machined features holding them at just the precise depth so they all fire at exactly the right time, just the right amount of pressure from the springs held in little captured pockets. And in order to create this, we used the CNC router table we've been talking about for some time here. We've been using it for a while with just the computer control. We have to get things all set up before we cut each part from this big sheet because, you know, the parts are small. So we tell it we have to start from here, and that requires going over to the computer and telling it to move this many millimeters this way, this many millimeters that way, and then you got to get it to just touch the surface in order to know where the top of the material is. And so that is a lot of back and forth. So we wanted to have a pendant, as they call it, a device to control the mill while you're standing here so you don't have to go back to the computer. So we came up with a PS3 controller, because we didn't want to just get one off a shelf. That's no fun. So we put together a PS3 controller system talking to the computer through a Bluetooth dongle and allowing us to control it remotely, wirelessly. So say I want to start from here, I can hold down the X and move it over in the X direction with proportional control. So get it just about right, and there it is. Y, right down there. Say that's just about right. And then we've got to make sure that the tip touches. So hold down L and then drive it down. This is where proportional control on the joysticks comes in great handy. Just a little bit till we're just about touching. Then we turn the speed down with the D-pad. Not quite that far. Bring it in. And that's good. And then we go over to the computer and tell it to start cutting from there. And that way we get parts with very precisely machined depths. And we don't care too much about the X, Y. It's very good in that on its own. But depth is the main thing to control there. One of the interesting things about using a wireless device to control this is making sure that it doesn't die on you and confuse the computer. The computer has to know when it's working. So we've been using the accelerometer data that comes out of this thing in a constant stream, even when it's sitting still, to tell the computer that it is still alive. And that allows this to be used very safely so we can produce great things for our NeonFM arcade machine.